Let's take a closer look at the NFL and all the things associated with it. For that, we're joined by Daniel Cangelli. He's a professor and academic director at NYU's Preston Robert Tisch Institute for Global Sport. Great to have you with us on the show. And this has been something I think a lot of people have kind of been waiting for and watching. The National Football League, the most lucrative league around, has long been barred from private equity firms from owning a piece of its teams. And right now, it means just a small equity stake is allowed. But it's a huge, significant change, wouldn't you say?
It's a tremendous change because even though it's a passive opportunity up to 10% compared to the NBA, the Major League Baseball, NHL, MLS, and the NWSL, who have allowed their teams up to 30%, the bottom line is the NFL has opened the door. And so opening the door to Arctos Partners, to Ares Management, to Sixth Street, it does allow for lucrative investments and also for stability for the future.
So a team can now sell basically 10% of its team to equity operation. But that's going to translate into millions and millions of dollars if the average NFL team is worth $5.5 billion. Firstly, what's it mean and what will they do with all this cash?
The additional cash would go into infrastructure updates. The NFL is long known to be to lag the market, where the NBA, NHL are a bit more aggressive with innovation. The NBA was the last to implement 5G technology into their stadiums to embrace AR and VR. But when they embrace it wholeheartedly. So the influx of cash is going to go to a lot more innovation for the NFL. Excited about the future for the NFL and their teams.
Yeah, I always heard it called the No Fun League, but I guess that's going to change pretty quickly. So what is this going to mean for the future sales of NFL team? From everything I've read, the operations rather, it really won't signal a big difference in the way teams run. The Jerry Joneses, the Mara family, the Hollis clan, others are still going to be running teams the way they always have.
Yes, the overall structure of the league and the way the franchises are set up is still the same. Individual owners like Jerry Jones must still maintain a 30% majority. And so within that system, it still allows for the traditional owner to be the head honcho, per se, for NFL teams. But one thing that was pretty surprising about the new deals is that no sovereign wealth funds were allowed to have a direct investment. So there's no Qatar sports investment, which has done great in the English Premier League. There's no Saudi public investment fund, which was big with LIV Golf. And so if Saudi Arabia and Qatar want a piece of the NFL, they have to join one of the consortiums.
Wow, that's going to be interesting. Okay, and right now these firms that you were talking about, they serve as kind of a silent partner. But do you think that could change in the future? And as you mentioned, other sports, Major League Baseball, the National Basketball Association, hockey, soccer, they've all had equity ownerships for a while. The NFL clearly, and the NFL, other than the difference from those other pro sports, they want a cut of the equity profits.
Yes, I think this is just the NFL sticking their big toe into the pond. what we're seeing with the other leagues is a full investment up to 30%. And so with the NFL's 10%, this is seeing if it works and seeing if the profits are worth it, if the dividends on the end are going to pay off, if both sides are going to be able to maintain a happy medium. I think it will. It will work. The numbers are there. The NFL is stable. But more importantly, this global expansion as the NFL seeks to have a larger presence in Europe, a larger presence throughout England, a larger presence throughout Germany, the game tonight in Brazil. And so you see that the global presence, the NFL is doing the right things to hedge on their investments.
Okay, what kind of issues, though, do you think could crop up between the league and the teams? Because the owners are very strong. They have Goodell, who's been the commissioner for some time, and I think largely has been kind of looked upon as someone who is very favorable to those owners.
Yeah, I believe that with the influx of cash, the NFL is going to feel as though in a few years they're leaving a tremendous amount of money on the table. And so if rival leagues across North America are all allowing up to 30%, it would be in the NFL's best interest to increase those numbers and to allow the private equity firms to have a larger investment of cash into these organizations. And then, of course, then maybe in the future, the sovereign wealth funds, because that's just leaving a tremendous amount of money on the table, and it just doesn't make sense for the long haul.
Man, that's amazing. Could this decision, you think, impact college sports at all? Because we've seen that been upended to a huge degree with NIL money coming in. And I just heard a couple weeks ago in one of the weekend college sports things talking about the Ohio State team worth $20 million that they're making. I mean, these college kids are making a fortune right now. Do you think that this kind of money could make its way into the college mode?
I do believe so. Ohio State, yes, the most expensive team on the field this year, and then of course followed by the University of Oregon, which has a large influx of Nike money from Phil Knight.
Sure.
And then of course the University of Colorado Boulder, which they had a deal in place with Saudi Arabia to bring in NIL money, but it fell through at the last minute. And so with the NFL opening the doors to private equity investments, college football, the NCAA, they're next.